Well, it's good to have you with us on your World of Champions once again. This is a Saturday afternoon, day two of round five of the Brutal Fruit Netball Premier League for 2016. And it is the Mpumalanga Sunbirds who come up against the Golden Fireballs from Gauteng. Fireballs playing in the orange kit, a bit of yellowy and blue for the Mpumalanga Sunbirds. And an attempt there from Kitiwe Matebula. Work out for them though, and Matapula has another opportunity now. Nice pirouette from her on the edge of the circle, finds Duplessis. She's got Zama Ripino in front of her, but Duplessis started this match absolutely brilliantly.
That is obstruction goal attack.
I also like Tulip Kroger playing in the wing defense position, although yeah, she isn't able really to play for a whole match. I'm not sure, I'll go through the stats and see if she's played for a whole match. I don't think she has, but she's a terrific player. She brings a lot of quality onto the court, a lot of calmness, and a lot of ability as well. Good shot. Duplessis has come to the match with intention.
They're taking this game to the Fireballs, really, Kevin. They're playing clinical netball, and I love the way they're playing around the circle, really separating the defenders of the Fireballs, and that confidence of Duplessis in that circle is really inspiring.
That's an ugly play through Chantel Swart, and Bianca Roda will pull one back for the Golden Fireballs. But a lovely break in the centre pass for the Sunbirds has them leading by 8-7.
Stepping in the circle,
well, the Fireballs play against the Northwest Flames in their last match. This is the penultimate match, and I think the Fireballs Northwest Flames match next weekend could be quite an interesting one as Penta goes 3-3. That's the whole thing. I mean, if you look at Talia Fenty, if you look at Chantel Swart ordinarily, and well, one just has to look at the statistics when you talk about Irinski Stoltz, then you know, one does have to back up that with the accuracy of the statistics. Fenty looking for those quick inside and outside passes, and across the edge of the circle as well from Diana Klonkwani. I think by I can't imagine that's on Mungo Kwani, because he said outside, so it must be on Dino from Gwani, then the centre court player, surely. So what a brave feed from Kaputsu, but Fenter will accept the gift, and so will the scorekeepers. There's so much space available there for Bianca Roda that she actually almost had to run off the ball inside of her own circle. Don't often see that. Another goal for Mbukwana. Quickly recycled down the court though, and it's a lovely little feed from Theo Kofutso. Roda will make no mistake.
Sunbirds!
They got it back though through Marlies de Brain, and looking out of our commentary box window, I can see Mbukwana doing a little bit of a hop, skip and jump with their frustration. That's a nice conversion though from Bianca Roda. As Badenhorst once again looking to get past Tumi Manju. Nice ghosting into space there from Tulisile and Kleko.
Inside.
Great positioning there from Bukwana. You know, she just, I mean, she's using her defense skills in that circle, in that shooting position.
Now the court opens up to Talia Fenter. So we wait to see just how matters pan out. In the meantime, the score will keep on rattling along if the ball gets up here to Bianca Roda. Sunbirds looking to really make something count here. Diana Klonkwani not playing in the final quarter. I thought she had a good game up to then, but makes way for Tulisile and Kleko. And that's a nice goal for Mbukwana. Fenter to De Bruyne. How many times has that pass gone down the court? So many times she makes herself available again. That's Fenter. Very ambitious from that sort of range, I suppose, to have a shot. She's going to take the chance now.
Why not, if you can shoot them from that distance?
An opportunity here to go to 60 for the second time. And that's exactly what Talia Fenter then does, as she obliges with one goal away from the 60 mark. All the quarters won by the Golden Fireballs. Identical second and fourth quarter scores. Absolute dominant there from the Fireballs.